Hey guys, let's start with the fourth one. Verify that 1 comma minus 1 and plus 3 are the zeros of the cubic polynomial, where the given cubic polynomial is what? X cube minus 3x square minus x plus 3. And check the relation between zeros and coefficients. Okay, so they have not verified that. So they have given three values where 1 comma minus 1 and plus 3 are the zeros of the cubic polynomial. So the cubic polynomial is this, and check the relationship between zeros and coefficients as in this given question. They have given two questions, okay? We can divide this question into two parts, where the first part will be verify that these three values are the zeros of the cubic polynomial, okay? So this will be the first part, and the second part will be what? This is the cubic polynomial, and the second part will be what? Check the relationship between zeros and coefficients. Okay, we must check the relationship between zeros and coefficients. But here, let us first, as they have given the zeros of polynomial. But what should we do? We must verify the relation. Okay, we must, not verification of relation, we must verify that whether these are zeros of polynomial or not. Okay, we must state whether these are the given values are correct or not. Okay, so let us check whether these are the given values of zeros of polynomial or not. What do you do to check this? What you do? You consider like here, verify 1 comma minus 1. Okay, so let me write first where p of x, the given polynomial is what? Where p of x equal to x cube minus 3x square minus x plus 3. Okay, this is the given polynomial where p of x equal to x cube minus 3x square minus x plus 3. Clear? Now what you do? You go for, let us firstly find out plus 1. Okay, whether plus 1 is zeros of polynomial or not. Okay, so check or check whether this plus 1 is the zeros of polynomial or not. If x equal to 1, if x equal to plus 1, guys, if x equal to plus 1, what happens? Well, p of 1 equal to 1 cube, right? 1 cube minus 3 into 1 square minus 1 minus 1 plus 3. Okay, this will be the equation that we found. What you do? You try to add, you try to multiply, you multiply, you add, you subtract, and you will be getting a value. Let us find that value. Okay, so after a very long process where 1 into 1 into 1, 1, 1 cube 1, as we know, where 3, 1 square 1, 1 into minus 3, this gives minus 3, minus 1 plus 3 equal to what? Equal to what? What do? You go for your plus 1 minus 1 cancel. I would go like this. Okay, directly like plus 1 minus 1 cancel, minus 3 plus 3 cancel, this becomes 0. Or if you wanted to go with another form, you have minus 3 plus minus 1, minus 3 minus 1 becomes what? Minus 4. Plus 1 plus 3 plus 1 plus 3 becomes what? Plus 4. This is always becomes either this form or this form, the answer is always 0. Okay, so here we got what? We got an answer that's 0. 0 is the answer that we got, so the simplified answer. So therefore, what you do, guys, here, therefore by this I can state that therefore one is the zeros of the polynomial, zeros of the cubic polynomial, cubic polynomial. Alright, where plus 1, okay, where 1 is the zeros of the cubic polynomial, because if I substituted instead of the x value, if I substituted 1, okay, here I have substituted 1 instead of x value, so therefore I got the value as 0, so therefore 0 is the, where therefore 1 is the zeros of the given cubic polynomial. Clear? Are you getting it? Let me go for the next one, the second one. Let's understand more clearly by this. So now let's go for the second one. Here you have what? If x equal to minus 1, guys, we have placed 1, right? So if x equal to minus 1, what happens? P of x equal to minus 1, where P of x equal to minus 1 means minus 1 whole cube, right? Minus 1 whole cube, minus 3, minus 1 whole square, minus, here have minus 6, minus of minus 1, minus of minus 1 plus 3. Clear? Now where minus 1 whole cube means, minus 1 whole cube means minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1, plus 1 into minus 1 minus 1, so this becomes minus 1. Minus 1 whole cube means minus 1 as it is. Okay, now here 1 square, 1 into 1, 1 square, 1 into 3, 1 into minus 3, minus 3 becomes what? Minus 3 as it is. Okay, now you have minus into minus plus, so plus 1 plus 3. Now coming back to this, guys, here you can see where minus 1 plus 1 cancel. Is it correct? Yeah. Where minus 1 plus 1 cancel, minus 3 plus 3 cancel. Or you can go for the other way, where here you have minus 1 minus 3, this becomes minus 4. Plus 1 plus 3, this becomes plus 4. Where plus 4 minus 4 cancel, this becomes 0. Or that this also becomes 0. Clear? So here I can say, if I substitute instead of x value, if I substituted x value as minus 1, if x equal to minus 1, then the answer, the value will be what? The value will become 0. So 0 will be the value. So therefore I can say minus 1 is the zeros of the polynomial. Okay. Minus 1 is the 0 of the cubic polynomial. Okay. Clear? Now let me go for the next one, the third one. Here we are done with the first one. The first one is the zeros of the polynomial. Yes, plus 1 is the zeros of the polynomial. Minus 1 is also the zeros of the cubic polynomial. And let's go for the last one, the third one. Where here plus 3. Whether plus 3 is zeros of the polynomial or not. Check whether plus 3 is the zeros of polynomial or not. So here let me go like plus 3, right? If x equal to plus 3, p of x equal to 3, like plus 3 as it is. Now here what you do, you go for 3 cube firstly, because it's a cubic polynomial, right? Then we'll begin with 3 cube minus 3 into 3 whole square minus 3 plus 3. Okay, now here 3 cube means 27, right? 3 is 9, 9 is 27. Next, minus 3 into 3 square means 9, right? 3 square means what? 3 into 3, 9. So 9, 3 is a 27, right guys? Here minus 27, so minus 27. Minus 3 plus 3 as it is, this is equal to what? Here plus 3 minus 3 cancel, minus 27 plus 27 cancel, therefore we got what? 0. Therefore the value we got what? 0. So I can say here where plus 3 is the zeros of the polynomial, zeros of the cubic polynomial, clear? Plus 3 is also the zeros of the cubic polynomial. Now the thing is what? Check whether, or check the relationship between zeros and coefficients. Clear? We have proved that we know, and we have showed that, or we have verified that where plus 1, minus 1 and plus 3 are the zeros of the cubic polynomial. Now what you do? You try to verify the relationship between zeros and the coefficients. Okay, what are the zeros and what are the coefficients? Let's see. Now, according to the given question, firstly, let us assume that where let 1 be alpha, beta, gamma, you will be getting 3 values for coefficient. Here, you will be getting 3 values for alpha, beta, gamma. By this, we have known we have got to know that where plus 1, minus 1 and plus 3 are the zeros of the polynomials, right? We know that plus 1, minus 1 and plus 3 are zeros of the polynomial. Now what you do? You try to find the relationship between zeros and coefficients, as we have 3 relations, guys. In the quadratic polynomial, we have 2 relations where alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a, alpha into b that beta equal to c by a, right? We know in the quadratic polynomials, we got to know what? Alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a, alpha into beta equal to c by a. But coming back to the cubic polynomials, you'll be getting the third variable alpha, beta, gamma. Okay, alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a. We will be having 3 relations. So first relation is alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a. Second one is alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to c by a. Okay. Alpha beta plus beta alpha plus alpha gamma equal to what? C by A. And next, alpha into beta into gamma. Alpha into beta into gamma equal to minus D by A. Okay, these are the 3 relations, guys. Okay? These are the relations that we got in the cubic polynomial, where alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a, alpha beta beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to c by a, alpha into beta into gamma equal to minus d by a. Clear? Now what you do, coming back to this relation between the zeros and coefficients, okay? Relationship between the zeros and coefficients, where the zeros that we got, what? Let us firstly assume where alpha, let alpha equal to plus 1, okay? Let alpha equal to plus 1. And what else? Let beta equal to what? Minus 1. Hamara beta kaun hai? Minus 1 hai. So let beta equal to minus 1. And hamara gamma. Hamara mama. okay, let our gamma equal to 3, okay? So let us assume like this. As we know, where alpha equal to 1, beta equal to minus 1, gamma equal to 3, plus 3. And coming back to the coefficients, we have what? We have a, where coefficients will be what, guys? Here, our cubic polynomial is x cube plus bx square. Bx square plus cx plus d, right? So this is the cubic polynomial. Now the coefficients are what? Where a, b, c, d are the coefficients, okay? Now, here a, b, c, d are the coefficients, where a equals to, if a equals to what? According to the given cubic polynomial, where a equal to 1, okay? And what else? B equal to how much? B equal to minus 3. Okay, minus 3. B equal to minus 3. And what else? C. C value. C value equal to what? How much? Minus 1. Because I have got minus x, right? X means it's we don't have any value for x. So therefore, 1 will be the value. 1 will be the value, okay? Where C equal to minus 1. And next, what else? The last one, D. D equal to 3 plus 3. Okay, now here a equal to 1, b equal to minus 3, c equal to minus 1, d equal to 3. Okay, d equal to 3. Now what you do, you instead of gamma, it's nothing, we know here comes the easy process, guys. What you do, you instead of gamma value, we know what, alpha value, we know what, 1. Okay, now place, instead of alpha value, you place 1. Instead of beta value, you place what? Minus 1. Instead of mama value, means gamma value, you place 3. Okay, like that. And b value minus b, right? So instead of minus b value, you place what? Minus 3. Right, so you go with that. Firstly, let me go with the first relation. Let us first find the first relation between zeros and coefficients. Okay, these both are, okay, let us find the relation between these both zeros and coefficients. Okay, let's find out. Here I have alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a, alpha beta gamma. Yeah, well, let me go with it. Where alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a. Now alpha value is 1 plus beta value is what? Minus 1 plus of minus 1. And gamma value is plus as it is. Here gamma value is 3, right? So this is equal to minus b. Minus b means minus 3. Minus of minus 3. Because we got minus 3 over here, where b carries minus and 3 also carries minus. So minus of minus into minus. So minus by a value is what? 1. Okay, a value is what? 1, as you can see. Now here, plus 1, plus into minus, minus. So minus 1 minus plus 3. This is equal to minus into minus 3, right? So plus 3 I got. 3 by 1, where 1 is not counted. Where if you, here you have, a, if the denominator carries 1, then we only consider the numerator, right? So therefore, let us consider only numerator 3. Now what you do? Cancel. Plus 1, minus 1 cancel. We got 3, where 3 equal to 3. As I can say, alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a, where this relation is correct. Okay, this alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a, that these both are having the true relation. Okay, both are same, right? We got the values where 3 equal to 3. You have positive 3, you have positive 3. There is no negative or positives or other values more than 3, right? So therefore, these both having a true relation. Okay, this relation is proved. Okay, this relation is correct. Clear? Are you getting it? Now let's go for the next one. The second one, where alpha, beta, beta, gamma, gamma, alpha. Come here. So let us invite our new relation. Alpha beta, alpha value is 1 into beta value is what? Hamara beta minus 1. Okay, alpha beta, beta gamma, beta kari, okay, minus 1 hua. Or mama 3. Sorry. Okay, let me go like alpha is 1, gamma is what? 3. Okay, there. Okay, let me go like clear. Now here, where 1 into 1 plus 1 into minus 1, this gives what? Plus into minus, minus. So minus 1 plus into minus, minus, right? Minus 1 as it is. Here you have 3, right? Wait a minute. Here you have 3 into, let me write plus over here. 3 into minus 1 minus 3. Okay, as it is, we either, if you go like this way or this way, both will be same. Okay, now here you will be adding 1 into 3, right? So plus 3 as it is. Now here plus into minus what, guys? Plus into minus what? Minus 3. Okay, minus 3 plus into minus minus, so minus 3. Minus 1 minus 3 plus 3 I got. Now this is equal to what I have said here, alpha beta beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to c by a. C value is what? Minus 1 by a value is what? 1. Clear? A value is 1. So as denominator is having 1, okay, denominator is having 1, where denominator value we won't see, okay. Well, denominator value, we won't consider denominator value because our eyes are blind. My eyes are blind. So what would I do? I won't consider denominator value. What I do? I would cancel by minus 3 plus 3 cancel. Okay? Minus 3 plus 3 cancel, then I get what? Minus 1 equal to minus 1. Okay? So, okay guys, here you don't consider denominator values because every denominator, if I write like 2, then here it would be 1. Okay, if I go with 3, then the denominator would be 1. So we won't consider the 1 in the denominator value. So here I am not considering this 1. So then what happens here? I have got minus 1 over here, I have got minus 1 over here, where minus 1, minus 1 both are same. So what do I do? Where alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to c by a, where this is correct. Okay, hence we have proved. As they have given, clear? The second relationship is also correct. Okay. Now let me go for the next one. Alpha beta, alpha into beta into gamma. Alpha into beta into gamma equal to minus d by a. Alpha value. You know, if you write these values like this, then it will be easy to find those values. Okay. Let us. You write if you know by performing an exam also. You firstly write those values. Keep it aside and you do this, then it won't take much time. Okay, now you have got alpha beta into gamma. Alpha value is what? 1. Beta value is what? Minus 1 into, right, multiplication, alpha into beta into gamma. Gamma means 3. Okay, where this is equal to minus d value is what? Minus d, minus 3. Okay, minus 3 by a value is 1. Okay, now what you do? Plus into, where plus 1 into minus 1, this gives minus 1. Minus 1 into 3, this gives what? Minus 1 into 3, minus 3. Okay, I would like to go right directly. So here, where plus into minus, minus 1, minus 1 into 3, minus 3. So minus 3 equal to, here, where denominator we got 1. So 1 is not considered, we won't count 1. So therefore, I got what? Minus 3 equal to minus 3. Clear? Where alpha into beta into gamma equal to minus d by a, where here I have got what? Minus 3 equal to minus 3. So therefore these both relationship also correct, true relation. Okay, so their relationship is also correct. Okay, where we both got, right? So we can say, I can state that where alpha beta alpha into beta into gamma equal to minus d by a, I can say like that, right? Where here I got minus 3. Okay, so this will be the alpha beta gamma equal to this will minus d by a. Okay, so here I can say that where this is equal to where alpha beta gamma is, I am getting minus 3, or minus d by a also I got what? Minus 3 value. So therefore this both are correct, right? This both are true, this both are correct, I am saying. Or if you go like this, where here alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a, so alpha plus beta gamma I got what? 3. Where this is equal to minus b by a, I got the value that I got is also 3. So therefore this both are equal, so therefore this formula is also equal, is correct. Okay, the formula that we have written is correct. Okay, so these both are equal. This is what we have stated, right? So we have checked the relationship. So just write it like this and leave that question. So this is what we can present in the examination hall. But you know, hope you got it, where we have checked the relationship between zeros and coefficients, and we have verified 1 comma minus 1 and plus 3 are the zeros of the cubic polynomial, where cubic polynomial will be having 3 zeros and quadratic polynomial will be having how many zeros? It will be having 2 zeros. Clear? Thank you.